should have touched on earlier, it's extremely pertinent to the entire Area 51 issue. Biden sort of asks, could you be more precise when you say that this elite is not part of the government? And I mean, they are chosen among high-ranking employees of the federal government, right? Are they only military, or some of them are civilians? And to quote verbatim my answer, yes, they are appointed by the government. But what has happened? They have become megalomaniacs with all the power and secrecy that they've been given. They have exploited those powers to secretly usurp the government, occasionally making unwitting puppets of presidents. The elite is comprised of both military and high-ranking public officials, while the sub-elite are mostly military. They see themselves as Nietzsche Ubermensch, while those who work for them are the Untermensch. All non-governmental civilians are alternately classified as organic resources or biological assets. There are certain exceptions, however, such as those with special education or those with Einsteinian-caliber intellects. While the general agenda is fascist, they do not discriminate against any ethnicity and have, from what I know, at least one high-ranking African-American within their circle. To delve deeper into my story, without me having to repeat everything, I suggest that everyone who watched these videos, if they haven't done this already, be sure to check out all the comments on my profile page. But yes, from what I understand, the elite I often refer to have a very Dr. Strangelove-esque mentality. Now, tonight, I wish to cover cattle mutilations. As you know, the regions most laden with this phenomena, New Mexico, Arizona, Nevada, etc., are near many of the atomic bomb tests sites during the 30s and 50s. And of course, UFO deaths attributed to aliens. And what a species that is highly evolved enough and scientifically advanced enough to travel millions of miles along with a tunnel-walking hamburger. I have no idea, but there are also those attributed to satanic cult sacrifices, which there's never been any evidence that satanic cults practice such bloody sacrifices, and the average skeptic attributes it to the common predators. And the truth is, common predators like coyotes are probably responsible for many, if not most, of the mutilations. However, through my colleague, I have learned that elements within Area 51 are responsible for at least some of the mutilations throughout the Southwest. And the purpose of this is to test for lingering radioactive contamination in the livestock from all the nuclear and atomic weapons tests from the 50s heyday. And if you look to find what types of organs are usually removed from the bovine carcasses, you'll find that they are the exact organs that would be required to test for such contamination. And many of the wounds present on the carcasses seem to be made with a precision-type laser, which I can assure you the military is in possession of. A variety of such weapons, in fact, just do a little research and you will find that they do indeed exist. Also, eyewitnesses have spotted black helicopters at or around the site of cattle mutilation incidents. And I can tell you that Area 51 houses a veritable fleet of these black helicopters that were designed and constructed by McDonnell Douglas. And they are equipped with a special rotary propeller system that renders the propellers and engine virtually silent. And this is something that's in the right territory. You can do a little research yourself and find out that these do indeed exist. You don't have to take my word for it on this one. Now, you may ask, well, why doesn't the military just go out and buy their own herd of cattle to test? A, it would raise too much suspicion, and B, they require random, uncontrolled samples to properly evaluate the level of contamination. And from what I know, the findings have been highly disturbing, which may explain the exponential growth in cancer rate over the last 50 years. Anyway, they usually test these bovine carcasses while